Yes, here is the problem is given. A farmer moves along the boundary of a square field. So we have to draw a square here. And this is the square field moved by the farmer of side 10 meter. So each side is 10 meter. This is 10, this is 10 meter, and this is 10 meter, and this is also 10 meter. So we have to write the data or draw the figure for the data given. I am naming it as A, B, C and D. If he starts at A and comes to B, C, D and A, then the time for covering this much distance is 40 seconds. What will be the magnitude of distance and displacement of the former at the end of 2 minute 20 seconds? So time is not 40 seconds, so it is time given is equals to 2 minute 20 seconds. 2 minute is 2 into 60 seconds plus 20 seconds. 2 into 60 is 120 plus 20, which is equals to 140 seconds. So we have to find out how many times he moves along the boundary of the field. For one complete move, 40 seconds is needed. But 140 seconds, how many rounds? It will be 140 by 40 is equals to 0 gets cancelled. 4 ones are 4 threes are 12, 0.45 is 20. So he can move along this boundary 3.5 times. Okay, I'm going to find out the distance first. Right, distance is the length of the path followed by him. The length of the path means from here A to B to C to D to A. This is first and second and third and half, 3.5 times. Distance is equals to, for one time his distance is 40 meters. 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 for 3.5 times. His distance is 3.5 into 40, which is equals to, so he covers 140 meters. Now displacement. So first round, he starts at A and comes to A. His displacement is 0 because starting point and ending point is same. For second round, he starts at A and comes to A. Again, it is 0. For third round, he starts at A, comes to A. It's also 0. And finally, the half round. Half round means he starts at A, comes to B and comes to C. So this is the displacement. Okay. So the three rounds, the displacement is 0. Because displacement is the length between the starting point and ending point. So there is no displacement. The only displacement is this 0.5 times. In 0.5 times, he starts at here and moves to here and moves to here. So A to C. So we should not say displacement is 20 because this is not a particular direction. So we need to find out this diagonal because this is the particular direction, right? So for that, I have to use AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. This is a mathematics formula. This is Pythagoras law, right? From here, AC is equals to under root of AB square plus BC square is equals to under root of AB square is 10 square plus BC square is again 10 square. So it is 100 plus 100, which is equals to under root of 200 is equals to under root of 100 into 2 is equals to root 100 is 10 and root 2 meters. So this is the displacement covered by the farmer. This is the problem. What is the speed and velocity of body A from the graph? This graph nu upayoginchi manam speed and velocity enta chudali. So to find out the speed and velocity, we have to note where the body is started and where it is ended, and it must be taken very accurately. Because the body starts at 15 meter on plus y axis, and it moves down and it comes to 10 meter on negative y axis, and again it moves to 20 meter on positive axis. So the time taken for this A, if you draw a line, it will meet at 8. So total time taken by the body is 8, and total distance covered. First, to find out the speed, we need distance and time. So speed is equals to distance by time. So what is the distance it covers from 15? Here to here is 15 plus distance, no direction. So from here to here it is 10 plus from here to here it is again 10 plus from here to here it is 20. So the total distance covered by the body is 15 plus 10 plus 10 plus 20. So it is equals to 30, 40, 55 by time. So from 0 to 8 means 8 seconds is equals to 55 by 8. So 6.88 meter per second. This is the speed. Now I am going to find out the velocity. Velocity is equals to displacement by time. So what is the displacement? It should be in a particular direction. So to find the displacement, first of all, it is here and it is here. Just it moved from here to here on y axis. So displacement is equals to 5 meter only by time. Time taken by it is 8 again. So it is 5 by 8. If you calculate, so it is 0.62 meter per second. In this way, you have to find out the speed and velocity if the graph is given. This is the other problem. An artificial satellite is moving in a circular orbit of radius nearly 42250 km. Calculate the linear velocity if it takes 24 hours to come revolve around the Earth. Okay, so we have to write down the data given, and the radius is given, and it is radius represented with R, and it is 42250 kilometers, and time is given. Time for one rotation, one revolution is 24 hours. 24 hours, if you convert into seconds, it will be 24 into 60 into 60, which is nothing but 86,400 seconds. Now it is revolving around the Earth, so it is circular path. So that distance will be the circumference of the circle, which is equals to 2 pi r. Okay, so the speed, linear speed, he asked to find out. So linear speed is equals to distance by time, which is nothing but 2 pi r by time. 2 into pi is 3.14 into r. R is 42250 by time is 86,400. If you calculate all these things, okay, you will get 3.1 approximately you will get 3.1 kilometer per second. A stone is thrown vertically upwards with a velocity of 5 meter per second. What will be the height attained and time taken by the stone to reach that height? Here two problems are given. One is we have to find out the height, the maximum height reached by the stone, and we have to find out the time taken by the stone to reach the maximum height. So for easy calculations, in the problem it is given that acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. Actually g value on Earth is 9.8 meter per second square, right? But for easy calculations he has given 10 meter per second square. Actually, what is acceleration due to gravity? A simple definition for acceleration due to gravity is the acceleration of a freely falling body. If you drop a body from certain height, initially it is at zero velocity, the velocity is gradually increasing, so there will be acceleration. If you calculate that acceleration, it will be 9.8 meter per second square. If it is on moon, it will be 1.67 meter per second square, right? So we have to first imagine how it is happened. A stone is thrown vertically up. So I am throwing a stone from here with a velocity of u is equals to 5 meter per second. I am going to find out the maximum height. let this is the maximum height. So the velocity here is zero. So the final velocity is 0 meter per second, and I have to find out the displacement. Displacement is S. Here I can use H because height is there. So I have equations of motion in which I have V is equal to U plus AT, which is not applicable here because the displacement is not there in V is equal to U plus AT. And second equation is S is equals UT plus half AT square. This is also not applicable because here it is T, T, I am not given the time. So this should not be applied. And third equation is V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. This can be applied. This is the data. Initial velocity is 5 and final velocity is 0. And acceleration is G, which is equals to minus 10. Why I wrote minus 10? Here the velocity is 5 and here the velocity is 0. Means velocity is gradually decreasing. So there will be negative acceleration. So I can say retardation. So it is minus 10 meter per second square. If you calculate acceleration due to gravity for a freely falling body, it will be plus 10 meter per second square. Next, displacement. Yes, I am taking it as H because I am taking it as height. So I have the formula. V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. From here I can write V is 0 square minus 5 square is equals 2 into, in the place of A, I am going to write minus 10 into S. This is, I have to find out H implies minus 5 square is minus 25 is equals 2 into minus 20 into H. H is equals to 25 by 20. 5 fours are and 5 fives are is equals to 5 by 4, 4 ones are, 4 ones are 0.4, 4 twos are 8, 4 fives are. So it will be 1.25 meters. If you throw a stone vertically up with 5 meter per second, if the acceleration due to gravity is 10, then the height reached by is 1.25 meters. Now I am going to find out the time taken from V is equals to U plus AT. V is 0 and U is 5 minus 10 into T implies phi is equals to 10 T, T is equals to 5 by 10, which is equals to half a second. Here is a problem. A train travels the first 15 kilometers at a uniform speed of 30, the next 75 with 50 kilometers per hour, and lost 10 kilometers at a uniform speed of 20 kilometers per hour. Calculate the average speed for entire journey. So what is the total displacement of the train? First of all, I have to find out total displacement is given by first 15 kilometers, next it travels 75 kilometers, next it travels 10 kilometers. So it will be 15 plus 75 is 90 plus 10, it is 100 kilometers. So totally this is 100 kilometers. And first 15, next 75, next 10. First 15 kilometers. This is 15 kilometers. And the speed here is 30 kilometer per hour. And here second is 75 kilometers. And the speed here is 50 kilometer per hour. And third is, this is 10 kilometers and the speed here is 20 kilometer per hour. To find out the average speed is nothing but average speed is total displacement or distance by total time. I have total displacement, there it is 100, but I have to find out the total time. Let the time to travel from here to here is t1, and from here to here is t2, and from here to here it is t3. Okay, now t1 is equals to, we have v is equals to d by t. From here we can write t is equals to distance by velocity. Here the distance is 15 by velocity is 30 kilometer per hour. So 15 ones are, 15 twos are, this is half, it is in hours, so it is half hour. Okay, Next here, T2 is, total distance is 75 by velocity. Velocity is 50. So 25 twos are, 25 threes are. So this is 3 by 2 hour. Half hour can be written as 0.5 hour and 3 by 2 is 1.5 hour. And finally, T3 is equals to, T3 is, the displacement is 10 by velocity, there it is 20. 10 ones are, 10 twos are. Again, it is half hour. Half hour means it is 0.5 hours. So total time, let it be T is equals T1 plus T2 plus T3, which is equals to 0.5 plus 1.5 plus 0.5. It is equals to 2.5 hours. Total time is at, therefore, average speed is equals total distance is 100 by, this is 2.5. So to calculate, easy calculation, the point can be removed, so I can keep it is 1000 by 25. 25 ones are, 25 fours are, and 0. So it is 40. In numerator it is kilometer and denominator it is hour. So the average speed of the train is 40 kilometer per hour. This is the problem given. A bus starting from rest moves with a uniform acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square for 2 minutes. Find the speed acquired and the distance traveled. First of all, you have to write the data. Starting from rest means initial velocity is 0 and acceleration is given 0.1 meter per second square. Time is given 2 minutes. I have to convert it into seconds, which is equals to 2 into 60, 120 seconds. Speed acquired. So I have a formula, V is equals to U plus AT, where V is the final velocity. V is equals to U is 0 plus A is 0.1 into 120. Is equals 0.1 into 120 is 12 meter per second. This is the solution for the first one, the speed acquired. And second is the distance traveled. We have two formulas. We can find out the distance traveled using S is equals UT plus half AT square, or V square minus V square is equals 2S. Let us consider S is equals to UT plus half AT square. S, the distance covered, S is equals UT. U is 0 into T is 120 plus half into A is 0.1 into T square. T square is 120 square. This is nothing but 0, and half into 0.1 into 120 into 120. 2 ones are 260. So this is 7200 into 0.1 is equals to 720, which is in meters. So this is the way to find out the displacement. You can use one more formula also, that is V square minus U square is equals to AS. Already V is there, minus 0 square is equals 2 into 0.1 into S. 144, 12 square is by 2 into 0.1 is equals S. 2 ones are, so this is 72 by 0.1. So I can write it is 720 by 1 is equals to S. So the displacement S is equals to 720 meters. Here is one question. The driver of a train traveling at a speed of 40 meter per second applies brakes as the train enters the station. The train slows down at a rate of 2 meter per second square. So the retardation is given, it is minus 2. The platform is 400 meter long. Will the train stops in time? So what is given, we have to write. The initial velocity is given. Meter per second, and acceleration A is given as minus 2. As the train is slowing down, we have to take minus 2 meter per second square, because after applying brakes, the velocity gradually decreases. velocity decreasing means you have to get retardation, so it is -2 m/s² and the platform is 400 meters long. How much distance it has to cover? Distance S is equals to 400 meters. Will the train stops in time? So for that stopping means the final velocity should be, final velocity should be 0. I want to find out the time. So 40 to 0. So we have V is equals to U plus 80. From here I can keep 0 is equals to U is 40 minus 2 into T. 40 is equals to 2T implies T is equals to 40 by 2, which is equals to 20 seconds. Means after applying brakes, the train moves for 20 seconds. In 20 seconds, it has to cover the distance of 400 meters. If it covers more than 400 meters, it cannot stop. Okay? If it covers less than 400 meters, it cannot reach the stopping point. So we have to find out the displacement using this data. So we have S is equals to UT plus half AT square. In place, yes, I'm going to find out U is 40 into time is 20 plus half into A is minus 2 and T square, which is 20 square. Implies S is equals to 40 into 20 is 800 plus into is minus, this 2 cancel, 20 square is 400. Implies S is equals to 800 minus 400, which is equals to
400 meters.
So if he applies brakes when it is traveling with 40 meter per second and if his retardation is 2 m/s², then in that time he will definitely reach 400 meters. So, will it stop in time? We have to say yes by calculating.